Stealth mission where you have to infiltrate a ship and sneak around taking down occupants not to alert any suspicious.
Oh yeah, I barely tried to do like these things.
Are you kidding me? You grab some weird distance. We don't know how pirates work. They don't trust anyone, even themselves.
I'm going to use that as outro music one day.
And you have to push away pirates that are so hell-bent on looking cool when they kill you, they still have their aviators glued onto their way. You escape the ship just in time, and when you wake up on the beach, Buck is there to greet you. Get the fuck out!
Come on! Oh! I'm dead. I'm so dead.
Finding out you didn't get the knife, he begins to talk to you by saying how Keith isn't doing too great. See, Buck is not doing too great. Still enjoys playing the show. He maintains the composure of Hoyt, but the insidious and take advance. I believe on these missions, he knew all along where the location of the knife was, but he sends you to your death multiple times just for his amusement. This is further proven when you follow the compass to the next marker. Buck's there waiting for you. Oh, why didn't you just playing that bloody game, you are. Expected to show, eh? Also, he does that video game thing where he puts you on the game to be the planet. You don't dare to stick to the human internal route for the proceedings. Anyway, you end up in Africa and find that the pirates are already there. I can only assume Doc sent them to the location for being Far Cry 3 really hasn't tried yet. Once you get past the giant holding wall, you are in a pirate. They only managed to prove so far underground, and now you're in uncharted territory. The environment changes massively as well, slowly turning into this ancient sunken city collapsing around you. There are pitfalls, big buttons you have to press in. There's even a puzzle where you have to shoot support beams to raise the water to escape. Not exactly 300 IQ gaming, but it's nice the devs tried something new here. It made me feel like I was back on my PlayStation 1 playing Tomb Raider before I actually had any real life responsibilities. If you're a 90s kid, phase 1 subscriber. As soon as it's getting good, the mission ends. You pick up another compass
and I guess
the cave in, and in true Indiana Jones fashion, you have to escape. You can even see an overview of the entire lost city, but you don't get to explore it. The
put the ball punch, fuck your power
and I just push this double. After escaping, you're greeted by Buck again, who turns sour and finding out you don't have the dog. Again. I don't have the knife, alright?
No.
Chase, that's not alright! Too busy playing games, aren't you?
Oh, fine. I'm playing a game of the town of Dunkley. Work also alludes to knowing the location of the
market.
He even teaches you a little history lesson about the island. About empires to bring into the location of the island. He's more interested in your adventure than the actual market itself.
Isn't that what happened? And the treasure ships.
Hardest difficulty, by the way, though. There's pillars you can shoot at the enemy drops, although why would you if most of the enemies don't? I repeated this segment about 3 times to try and actually crush some of the drops. We went to an area of the pirates
I'm just gonna turn this off, thanks.
How have they survived down here, by the way? There's no other animals in water. Maybe this is my personal hell. Anyway, same thing as last mission. Pick up thingy, dive, cave falls in, and Buck is there to greet you.
Get the fuck off the property!
But this time it's a little bit different. Instead of being an errand boy, Jason builds up enough courage to properly confront Buck. He only backs down when he realizes if he does this, Buck ends the game and kills Keith prematurely.
Wait.
Why is phone screen a texture for the whole phone itself? This time before I got Buck, I got a good back
yesterday. Yeah,